Hey tech heads, Fina here. Welcome back to the channel. Today I want to test out an 11 kilowatt EV charger that I received from Depow, and we're gonna test it out at my friend's house. So Depow actually also sent me some adapters, so this will be the perfect place to test it out because my friend has an EV, but he does not have a three-phase socket. He just has a regular 200 volt socket. So we're gonna test out these adapters, we're gonna test out the charger, and we're gonna charge his Škoda Enyaq. So if you're interested in, you know, versatile charging solutions, come with me and let's check it out. Okay, y'all, so let's get to the unboxing. First, I'm gonna check out the adapters that I received. So I have three options here. I have a Schuko plug, a one-phase CEE 16 amp plug, and a three-phase CEE 32 amp plug. So that's really cool. Let's take a look at these adapters. These come in really handy, you know, especially when you're traveling or if you're out camping or something. So first off, let's unbox those. So that is the Schuko plug, I believe. Here we have the three-phase CEE plug. And this is our one-phase CEE 16 amp plug. So very nice. We're gonna get to test some of those out today. All right, now let's go ahead and unbox the charger here. So open her up. All right, awesome. So I have it in a nice bag, a nice travel case. I love that with the handle. Ah, and actually this is pretty cool. So the bottom of this bag is nice and textured. It's like a rubber texture. So if you don't happen to have a carpet in your trunk, this is cool because it's gonna stop that from sliding around. So that's pretty awesome. That's a cool attention to detail. All right, let's unwrap it. Okay, very nice. The bag is great. I have a little pocket here. Should I wanna, I don't know, keep my user manual in there or other small items, or maybe my cloth here that I see is coming up. And let's see the charger. All right, so first impressions, it is quite heavy. This is a 12 meter cable, so that's to be expected. You can actually get up to a 25 meter long cable, so that's really cool if you happen to have a charging spot that's pretty far from your car. So it looks like it's gonna be a nice quality here. We're gonna, of course, test it out, but just first impressions, it looks really good. The cable looks nice and strong, so that's awesome. I have a nice little cloth here for wiping the display because, you know, that thing's gonna get dirty from your fingers. So I like that. Good attention to detail again. And here we have, okay, so that's our standard wall holder and some screws to screw that in into your garage. That's awesome. And then let's check out this thing. Okay, so looks like this is gonna be a sleeve cover for the connector. So when you're charging in the winter, you can cover that up and it's gonna keep your connector warm. You can see it's nice and insulated. So that's awesome. Then of course we have a manual. So I'm gonna check that out, get some details. But right now let's get to testing. Okay, real quick, before we get to testing, I actually noticed one more thing in the bag, and that is this little holder. Looks like you can go ahead and wrap that around your cable. And then you can just carry it on its own. So that's pretty awesome. I just noticed that. I just wanted to show you that before we move on to testing. All right, so I have it plugged into my adapter. I'm gonna go ahead and plug this thing into the socket here. Let's see, this way. Let's see. Yep, my display is lit up, so I know I'm plugged in. So again, y'all, these adapters are a great solution if you just have a regular 200 volt socket at home, but you do have an EV. You know, you can just go ahead and get one of these adapters instead of figuring out a whole other situation with the socket. So that's a great solution. Okay, now let's check out the display, see what kind of options we have. I'm gonna take this little protective foil off here. So it's brand new. All right, come closer and let's take a look, see what we can do. Okay, so before we plug into the car, let's take a look at the options here. I did notice I can set up my current here. So I start at 6 amps. If I hold the button here, which is a nice little click, lets you know that it is moving on. Then here I see this is 8, 10, 13, and I can go all the way up to 16. So that is the option I'll be choosing. So that's nice. It's a small little writing here, but it is quite noticeable. So you can take a look at that. Now here, the other option I have is the delayed charging. And I did notice this is pretty cool. you can actually do it by 30 minutes. So not just by hour, but by 30 minutes. And that goes from 30 minutes all the way up to an 8-hour delayed start. I do like that these touch buttons let me know every time I press them, there's a little click just to let me know I didn't need press it. I'm going to go back to zero because we're going to charge this bad boy up. You can see the amps here. Now, it's showing nothing at this moment because I'm not charging yet. Obviously, I haven't charged anything yet, but we're about to plug it into the car. So let's do that, and then we'll come back to check out the display.
All right, y'all. So let's go ahead and plug her in, and then we're going to take a look at the display and see what kind of options we have. So I will be charging the Škoda Enyaq. Let's open it up. Check out the connector. All right, I'll plug her in. Okay, and I got the little signal. We are in business, so let's go check out that display.
Okay, so we've been charging. You can see here it's just been a minute now, so not for very long, but I do like this display. It shows me a little check mark that I'm connected correctly. It shows that the grounding is good. That's really nice information to have. I really appreciate that. You can see I'm charging 3.4 kilowatts. The real current is 14.9 amps. It does go up and down between 15 and 14.7. So some nice information, good informational display. So very nice and clear.
All right, y'all. So just so we can actually test out these adapters fully, I did want to go over to a different location where I have a 32 amp plug. So I'm going to plug this thing in. Get it. Got to use my strength here. There we go. So I'm going to be converting my 32 to 16. And that means I can still go ahead and use my charger. So, oops, I figured. There we go, plug her in and we can go charge up, and we're gonna be doing this one with my Megane E-Tech again.
Okay, so right now you're seeing the charger while it's charging my Megane E-Tech with the display showing the charging power. Thanks to high efficiency, it's delivering an excellent 10.7 kilowatts of the max 11 kilowatts. So you can see it really ensures very effective and speedy charging for your EV. I also really love that this charger prioritizes safety, featuring overcurrent, overvoltage, and short circuit protection to keep both your vehicle and the charger secure, and of course, to keep you safe. Plus, it offers the customizable charging time and the power settings, as I already mentioned, so you can adjust it to your needs, whether you want just a quick boost or you're going for a full charge overnight.
All right, y'all, so that is the Depow mobile charger, and I want to thank Depow again for sending me it and for sending me the adapters. These are excellent. I got to test out two of them. I'm going to test out this one-phase camping plug next time I go camping. It's a little bit cold for that now, so a little bit more time. Definitely make sure you check them out. It's going to be depow.de, and I'll definitely leave a link in the description as well. Please let me know if you have any questions or, you know, if you have any comments. Definitely write them in the comments below. Thank you all for watching, and I will catch you next time.